Hey there, I'm Eric, and today I'm going to be reviewing the AllPowers SP029 foldable solar panel. This is a 140 watt foldable solar panel from AllPowers. I've used quite a bit of their panels, and so when they offered to send this out to me, I was like, heck yeah, I'll definitely test it. This is a polycrystalline panel, so it is older technology. So I've already used this camping. I took a trailer from Amazon, spoiler alert, and I put an AllPowers generator in it, and I put this on top of it, and pretty much was able to drag it around and keep the generator charged up all day long. Then at night, I ran a projector screen and watched movies from that same generator. It has this nice little storage case so you don't lose all your wires. So inside that, first we got our alligator clips. These would just be used in an emergency to connect to a lead acid battery. Yeah, I definitely don't recommend those. There's no kind of charge controller to regulate that. But in a pinch, it could get your car started again. So it's not a bad little wire. From the panel itself, it does come with quite a long connection with the MC4 connectors. And then you also get a bullet there. Another wire that comes with it is MC4 to the XT60 there. I actually find that one quite helpful with a lot of my setup. That's what I use in the e-bike world is the XT60s. It's come with a series of bullet connectors. Basically, if the one that it comes with doesn't fit into the generator, they provided 5 there that should be able to adapt into just about any generator. It also comes with this little tiny controller on it. Say you don't have a generator or anything hooked up with it. You could set this up on the fly, plug your laptop into it, or charge from USB. It even has a USB-C there, which is nice. The SP29 is definitely built very convenient for carrying around. If you ever carried around a large ridge panel this size, you'd realize how cumbersome they can be. This is definitely nice. It has these 2 clips in the front, which allows then the panel to be unfolded. So I'm gonna go ahead and unclip them and fold out the solar panel. That's a little bit dirty for me using a camping. It's upside down. Eyelets on each one of the corners, just in case you wanted to hang it from something. And there's a look at the stats for the panel. Just go ahead and give it a pause if you need to get those. So it has these legs in the back that you pull out, and it has 4 of them to support the panel. And that's its basic setup there. Of course, I'm not gonna gather any solar inside of the house. So I'll show you guys my test rig real quick. So my test rig is a basic system. I put the meter on this side. So basically you're not measuring the performance of the controller, you're measuring the performance of the panel at that point. So this is a much better way. We'll show you the efficiency of the solar panel. So the solar panel comes in, goes into my meter, which I got battery backup hooked up into. So at night or a shadow, it'll keep my stats. This goes into a very high-end MPPT controller. It's called a Jennison. And then from there, it goes into the battery. This is just a connector there, nothing to be worried about. The battery itself is what I call a solar battery. So it has a common charge and discharge port. That wire you see over there is for maintenance. It's just to keep everything topped off. So I'm gonna basically wait for the sun to go down. I'm gonna place this out there and I'm gonna do an all day test on it and see what it performs at its maximum wattage and how much wattage it's able to pull. Keep in mind, my backyard isn't totally optimum for solar. It does have a wall and several trees, but it is in Phoenix, Arizona, so it does gain very good power. Okay, looks like the panel is totally in shade now. Surprisingly, it still is pulling 15 to 16 watts totally in shade. That's way more than monocrystalline would be pulling at this point. That's impressive at the low end. Let's go ahead and check the meter and see how much power it pulled. Okay, there you can see the 15 to 16 watts it's still pulling. Looks like it pulled 4.9 amp hours, total power of 398 watts in the whole time. So I crunched the numbers and got the results back. Okay, so to talk about the elephant in the room, the 83.1 watts ends up coming out to around 59% efficiency, which that isn't good, but there's a very good reason for that. This is polycrystalline technology, which is the older solar technology. It definitely has a higher temperature coefficient, so very rapidly as it increases temperature, the efficiency drops. I found when I was camping that I was pulling around 101 watts off it up there, and that was at a maximum of 85 Fahrenheit. So if you're able to get the panel close to 70 degrees, I have a high suspicion, and I will test that out coming this fall when I have temperatures like that. And they stand behind their product with a 2-year warranty, and they guarantee that it will produce that 80% power given it is the right temperature where polycrystalline can produce that amount. Fortunately, here in Phoenix right now, I don't have the environment to get the maximum wattage out of it. But it is a good test to see how it reacts in heat. Okay, for this panel, you can use a coupon code down below. It is ET10, and that'll get you 10% off this panel. Matter of fact, you can use it on any other solar panels or a solar generator, or some called battery boxes, or there's several names for them. I'm going with solar generator. If you don't like it, I don't know. I got nothing. So thanks for watching, and until next time. Don't eat yellow snow? No. Till next time, have a great day. Cut!